Father in heaven, we continue to lift you up. Father, we exalt you. We glorify you because you are the King of Kings and the Lord of Hosts. You are the El Shaddai. You are the beginning and the end. You are the Alpha and the Omega. Father, you are Jehovah Jireh. Even before we go up to the mountain of sacrifice, we glorify you, Heavenly Father. We worship you, King of Kings. We say you are worthy of all honor. You are seated high and exalted. You are above and lifted up. Father, today we exalt you. We lift up your name. We worship you. We say, come and take your place in our lives. Come and take your place in our families. Come and take your place in our marriages. Come and take your place in whatever we do. We thank you, Holy Spirit, because there is none like you. You are worthy of all honor. You are worthy of all praise. You are worthy of all worship. We thank you, Lord. Today we exalt you above our names. We exalt you above our families. We exalt you above our finances. We exalt you above our marriages. Father, we fall into your hands. For in your hands there is mercy. Father, many trust in chariots and others in gold. But we will remember the name of you, our Lord. Lord Jesus, we thank you because you are, we are your battle axe, Heavenly Father. And when we go into battle, we do not go as those who lose. For you wear the victor's crown and you ride against our enemies. We are on a white horse, Heavenly Father. Father, you are the one, Lord Jesus. And what more do we need than your word, Heavenly Father? Father, you are living, you are powerful. You are sharper than any two-edged sword. You pierce deep even between that division between bone and marrow, that division between soul and spirit. We praise you, Jesus. We glorify you, King of Kings. We thank you, Heavenly Father. We thank you, Lord. We worship you. We worship you, Lord Jesus. You are worthy of all honor. You are worthy of all praise. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Holy Spirit. Hallelujah. You are welcome to today's prayer. We have declared this a war zone for women. We are not here to pray for the government.
We are not here to pray for the weather.
We are not here to pray for the church to increase. We are here to
make
war. We are here to take back what the devil has stolen from us. We are here to declare that no one can come against us. While other women are in the world, visiting witch doctors, visiting cults, plotting acid attacks and ending up in prison forever,
we are saying
to the devil, we know how to do it. And our power is not in acid. Our power is not in witchcraft. Our power is in the name which is above all names. That name is above the name of your cheating husband. That name is above the name of your concubine. Your husband's concubine. That name is above the name of the divorce papers that are being filed against you. That name is above the name of your debts. That name is above the name of your illness. That name is above the name of the problem among your children. It is that name that will call today. Job chapter 5 verse 12 says, the Lord frustrates the devices of the wicked. And he brings their plans to no success. The Lord frustrates the devices of the wicked. Against our worker, against our businesses, join me. Thank you, Jesus. We are just going into a time of putting our hearts right with God. The word of God says it's the glory of a man to overlook an offense. He promises in his word that vengeance is his. And the battle belongs to the Lord. Many Christians walk around with bitterness.
Us
that you direct the footsteps of the righteous, and nothing happens to you without knowing. Father, before anything was in our life, you already knew. Nothing is too complicated and nothing is too hard. Nothing is too difficult and nothing cannot be changed. We come to you right now in the name of Jesus, and we decree and declare that we are free of fear, we are free of hatred, we are free of pain, we are free of worry, we are free of discouragement. Father, as we launch out into battle, we continue to pray that we will be victors. It is not a feeling. Faith is a feeling that comes after a decision. If you decide not to be fearful, not to be angry, not to be hateful, the combination of that equals faith. Anybody that says they have faith and they are hurt and they are worried and they are regret and they are bitter and they are unforgiving, that is not faith. So right now, we believe we have faith.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus. Sister Gift here. Yes, Sister Gift, we want to give thanks for her marriage. If you can come.
Sister Gift, I cannot go to Sakatomo.
Let's give Sister Gift a powerful hand.
Just the one that you're killing, that's what I'm saying.
Nanga chapa kundo no musoma Jessica ne pasa kanya zvato wate.
Yes, Lord.
Father, today we decree and declare
yes,
that
faithful. He is God of faith. Oh, he's a God of faithfulness. We have to just. As we pray for our children today, let us consider this faithful God. This God who has let sister gift you. Can he fail our children? This God who has made her happy. Can he forget our families and our children? The word of God says that if you devil hates the children of the righteous. And the first thing that even Adam were told in the Garden of Eden was that the enemy would bite the heel or attempt to bite the heel of our seed. But he also promised that the seed of a woman shall crush the head of that enemy. Your seed has the power